So you may have heard some songs by Drake or Kanye that claim to be made with AI voice cloning technology, and you're wondering if they're real or if they're actually just a hoax.
Well, folks, let me tell you, it's no malarkey. Here's the deal, guys. If you have the wherewithal to download a model or train your own, it's not hyperbole to suggest that you can essentially clone anyone's voice. I'm not joking.
And believe me, there are many, many models out there. They were saying it couldn't be done, but now we did it. They're calling it a scientific miracle. These models have been trained for thousands and thousands of generations, more generations than the world has ever seen before, and there's nothing anything like it. It's incredible.
But let me be clear. In order to really be convincing, you can't just say the words. You need to make sure that you talk with the same inflection and cadence of the person you're trying to impersonate. Not just because it's the right thing to do, but because if you talk like yourself and you have Barack Obama's voice, it ends up going into the uncanny valley and it just sounds kind of weird and people don't like it. It's just really creepy.
So in this video, I'll show you how I cloned my own voice using AI-powered technology. And I'll go over some ideas I have for things you can do with that technology, apart from making Kanye and Drake covers. So to create these voice clones, I used a project called so-vits-svc-fork. And this project focuses on speech-to-speech conversion using a trained model. So instead of converting text to speech, like you type some text that you want the person to say and it creates the audio, it actually takes audio as an input and then applies that cloned voice to it. So essentially it swaps one voice out for another voice in an audio file. So I decided to train a model using my own voice in order to supercharge my singing abilities. And one nice thing about this project is that you don't need to actually annotate any of the audio files that you're using for training. In other text-to-speech models, you have to actually write down the words that you said in the audio files in order to train. But with this one, you can just send it raw audio data and it'll train on that and spit out a model. I had a lot of clean audio data of myself speaking from all of the previous YouTube videos I've made. So I isolated all of it from my latest trombone champ video, and then I used a script to cut them into samples of about 10 seconds each. I also recorded about 6 minutes of myself singing various hits from the 80s and 90s, just so that my voice model can have an accurate representation of what it sounds like when I'm singing different pitches, aside from my talking voice. And so I trained this model for about 5,000 epics, and it spit out a model that works pretty well at copying my own voice. So now I'll take it to the lab and show you how it works in action. Okay, so here I am in the studio, and I have a voice recording that I've isolated of the song It Had to Be You. And the reason I use the song It Had to Be You is because It Had to Be You is actually in public domain. And so YouTube can't give me like a copyright strike or anything on this video if I sing the song because it's public domain. So what I did was I took a recording of it, which might not be in the public domain, could be, and I isolated the vocal part of it, and I then cloned my voice into that vocal track. And so this track sounds like me singing It Had to Be You. And I thought I would actually compare it to my actual singing of the song and see which one sounds better or see if the voice clone actually sounds like my real voice. So I'll just record a real quick track of this first part of the song and then compare. It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who. Okay, that might not have been completely in tune. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this a little bit louder. Okay, let's hear that, how that sounds. I mean, I just heard it because I sang it. It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who. Okay, not completely in tune. Let's see how the voice clone track sounds. It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who. Okay, so my voice is a little bit more raspy. I mean, I'm not a professional here, but that sounds pretty similar.
I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
I think you could be convinced that it's me. Okay, so the next thing that I try to do is take this track that I just recorded, whoops, and then try and clone some other voices into that track and see how they sound being sung by other people. So let's set that up. Okay, so I went ahead and used some models that I've downloaded from the internet and applied those models to my previous recording of It Had to Be You. And so let's compare my version with some of these other models that I found. So here's my version again really quickly. It had to be you. It had to be you. Okay, pretty good. Let's hear how Obama sounds.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Okay, that one's a little weird. I think there's different models that are based on data sets of people speaking and also of people singing. And so I'm guessing that the Obama model was probably made from recordings of Obama speaking, not so much him singing. And I found that the speaking ones don't do as well when they're trying to sing. And so you can hear, especially in like some sustained notes, let's try Trump.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Okay, so yeah, the sustained notes are a little bit weird. One thing I also noticed with some of these models is that it almost feels like it captures the person's accent. So like, he sounds like a real New Yorker, especially in this part.
I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Like, it seems like it almost changes the pronunciation of wandered to one wandered. Maybe it's just me, I'm imagining that, but I don't know. Let's try Biden.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Yeah, I feel like it actually just captures the accent because his Biden says wandered.
I wandered around.
Instead of Trump saying want.
I wandered around.
I don't know. Maybe I'm imagining that. Let's try Kanye.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Yeah, I think Kanye is just a perennial favorite of these AI cover songs. His voice is pretty good. I don't know, it's kind of soothing. And finally, let's listen to Elon Musk. Let's see what he sounds like.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
Yeah, so Elon Musk has a really gravelly kind of vocal fry voice. And again, I think it's just because this model's been trained on his speaking, and he probably just talks a lot like, you know, gravelly voice in his interviews or whatever, and that's probably where the model was trained. So that makes a lot of sense. Yeah, I just remembered that I also did a Michael Jackson one, but I forgot to put it in here. So let's see how Michael Jackson sounds.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
So it's a little bit weird. I haven't really played around with the settings that much, and I'm sure that if I, you know, mess with the settings a little bit more or cleaned up the original audio file, because I didn't do really any cleaning to the original file, maybe some of the noise would go in, it would sound a little bit better. But it actually sounds like Michael Jackson. It's got like the timbre of his voice.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who...
And of course it's out of tune because I sang out of tune. But anyway, that's just a quick look at a bunch of different models applied to one audio file. So now that we've explored how the voice cloning technology works, I wanted to talk a little bit about some ideas I had for using this technology aside from making myself and other famous people sing show tunes. So one idea I had is that artists could actually sing songs in languages that they don't even understand. For example, Shakira is bilingual, and so she has her song Hips Don't Lie both in Spanish and in English, because she can just sing both because she knows the languages. But any artist could actually sing in any language as long as they have a singing double who can sing songs in that language and then have that voice replaced with the original artist's voice. And while you don't necessarily need to understand the lyrics of a song to enjoy it, imagine a world where, say for example, K-pop artists could sing their songs in English and we'd finally understand what Gangnam Style is actually about. So along those same lines, I always try to make my YouTube videos accessible by adding captions so people who speak other languages can still enjoy my videos. I could take it a step further and use text-to-speech to create audio in a different language, and then apply my voice model to make it sound like I'm speaking that language. YouTube is actually rolling out a feature that allows multiple audio tracks, and I'm eager to experiment with it to see if I can expand the reach and accessibility of my videos. For example, here's what it might look like if I translated part of this video in a different language.
Ich könnte noch einen Schritt weiter gehen und Text-to-Speech verwenden, um Audio in einer anderen Sprache zu erstellen. Und dann wende ich mein Stimmmodell an, damit es so klingt, als würde ich diese Sprache sprechen.
One of the interesting things that's happening right now is that a lot of these AI voice clone covers are being taken down by music labels that are representing the artists. And the reason that's happening is that these songs are not actually authorized by the artists. But I could see a world where artists actually collaborate with people who are cloning their voice to generate new music. I actually had this idea a while back, but then I saw this tweet from Grimes basically saying that anyone who uses her voice to make AI covers can do it as long as they share half of their earnings with her. And so get ready for a flood of Grimes covers, I guess. So I imagine that most artists probably won't take people up on this kind of offer, but if you look at the numbers, and artists can actually make more money by collaborating with these people making these AI voice clones, then they might actually do it. We'll just have to see what happens in the future. So another interesting thing that I've been seeing happening is that when artists retire, they sell their entire music catalog. Like for example, recently Bob Dylan just sold his entire music catalog for a huge amount of money. So you wonder if some artists are actually getting ready to retire and they want to sell all of their music, perhaps they would also sell the rights to using their voice in new music and make it a bundle deal. And maybe Bob Dylan isn't the best example because his voice kind of sucks, but other artists like, say, Michael Jackson, imagine how much his voice might actually be worth if you could use it authorized in new music. And speaking of aging artists, I've actually noticed multiple models for some artists like Paul McCartney, where there's one model of them singing when they were younger and another of them when they're older. So it got me thinking that an artist might actually want to create their own model of their voice from back when they were younger in order to make their new music seem a little bit more youthful. And this doesn't just apply to musicians. There's also actors like Mark Hamill and Harrison Ford who've been playing the same characters for like 50 years. And they've even been using deepfakes and like replacing Mark Hamill with like a guy who looks almost exactly like Mark Hamill. But if they could actually deepfake the younger voices of those people, it might even be more convincing. So if you haven't heard of The Simpsons, it's this animated show that's been on for like 33 years. And just to give you an idea of how long it's been on, when it first came out, I was younger than Bart Simpson, and now I'm actually older than Homer Simpson. And some actors on the show have actually died during the run of it, and their characters have had to be retired. So I was thinking, what if they just made a voice clone of those characters so that they could still live on even though the original voice actor is dead?
And if you're thinking this is a terrible idea, well, don't have a cow, man.
So, not all use cases for this technology are actually good or legal. For example, I read an article where a scammer was trying to convince a parent that their teen was being kidnapped using a clone of their teen's voice, even though they were just hanging out with their friends. And I just actually read another article where someone was trying to sell some Frank Ocean tracks as like leaked tracks, but they were just AI fakes. And so I think this will happen more and more as people are getting aware that voice cloning is a thing, and it's something that they actually need to watch out for. And finally, I was thinking that I could use my own voice clone combined with my previous project on using ChatGPT to make phone calls in order to make phone calls with my own voice. So in case anything goes bad, I can just jump in with my own voice. Plus, I can use it to make prank calls to people and see if they can tell if it's a robot or if it's me. So as far as the future of voice cloning goes, I actually have no idea where it's going to be headed, but I do have a feeling that things are going to get really interesting. And as good or as bad as you think the voices actually sound right now, they're actually only going to get better with time and as the technology progresses. So I do see a lot of really interesting, but also potentially harmful use cases in the future.
Well, that's our show. Thanks for watching. As always, if you like this video, be sure to hit that giant like and subscribe button of science. And let me know what you think. Did you have any other ideas for using voice cloning technology? Should I start my own kids show about science based in Seattle? Leave me a note in the comments below. And if you'll excuse me, I have some celebrity voice AI training to do. See ya!